Hey guys, Dr. Berg here. I had another question regarding ketosis and sugar alcohol sweeteners, okay? Now, this is a list of mostly sugar alcohols, alternative sugar type sweeteners. Now, there are some other sweeteners that are not sugar alcohols, but so let's just kind of go through them. At the top of the list, this is the highest glycemic index. That's bad. As we go down, it's good, okay? So we don't want it very high, because glycemic index basically is a scale of how fast things turn into sugar and raise blood sugar. Maltodextrin is the highest, and this is why a lot of the electrolyte powders have maltodextrin. A lot of vitamins have it. You want to stay away from that stuff. It has 110. Glucose, that's 100. Sucrose, that's table sugar. Okay, so that's 65. High-fructose corn syrup, 58. But even though you might say this is lower, this can create insulin resistance very fast because it messes with your liver. Honey is 50. If you were going to do honey, I would recommend the Tupelo honey versus other types of honey. Then we have maltitol, which is 35. Xylitol, which is 12. This is the one that I use simply because it doesn't have an aftertaste. I get the non-GMO. Yes, it's definitely not zero. It's very minor, but if you have in small quantities, I have not found it to be an issue, but you may want to avoid it. Sorbitol, which is 9. Mannitol, 2. Erythritol is 1. This is a really good one. The problem with erythritol with some people is it gives them bloating and gas. So you might want to try it and see if it's okay with you, but make sure that you don't consume very much. Monk fruit is 0. This is a really good one. Then we have stevia also. I didn't put on the list, but that's 0 as well. So that just kind of gives you a relative system of values of really bad and really good. Thanks for watching. Hey, you probably already subscribed, but if you haven't, press this little button down below and I will keep you updated.